Will my vote count? That's the question we've been getting from some of you about using permanent markers on your ballots. In fact, that very issue has become a social media talker known as Sharpiegate. Our investigative reporter Lolita Lopez has answers now about that and what happens if your ballot is damaged.
Sorting, verifying, and processing vote-by-mail ballots in Pomona. Teams of people working around the clock, ballots still coming in. Remember, in California, ballots postmarked on or before November 3rd will be accepted through November 20th.
Every single employee will have four boxes in front of them.
It is inside this center where county election workers prepare them to be counted. Part of that is looking for any issues with the ballots. More than 75% of the millions of ballots tallied so far are mail-in ballots.
Let's say your ballot comes in and it's inadvertently been damaged, or while you were filling it out, you spilled coffee on it. We know our tally machine's not going to be able to read it. We have a process by which we could remake that ballot.
Sharpiegate started trending on social media when voters in other states became concerned that the heavy ink might spoil their ballot. While a blue and black ballpoint pen is the preferred method to fill out ballots in LA County, vote by mail operations manager Philip Rivera says Sharpies or permanent markers are fine. He explains the bubbles on the ballots are offset, so even if it did bleed through, it wouldn't affect any bubbles on the other side. Orange County ballots are similar to LA County. The registrar there tells the I-team ballots that are rejected get a manual review. We also heard from the San Bernardino County Registrar's Office. They tell us in an email, Sharpies are the preferred method for marking San Bernardino County ballots. That's why they were provided at the polling places. Any black or blue ink pen will also work, but Sharpies are recommended by the voting system vendor who provided the ballot scanners. In LA County, if a ballot can't be scanned, which can happen if, for instance, a voter puts a check mark instead of filling in the bubble, it's remade on the spot. Rivera explains an employee manually transfers the votes from the original ballot. A quality control clerk then reviews to ensure nothing was added or omitted, and both ballots are scanned to have a digital copy for record keeping. Rivera says as of Thursday, 34,550 vote-by-mail ballots have been remade. That's about 1% of all ballots counted.
We want to make sure that every eligible voter that cast a ballot, if it's valid, that we want to make sure give them every opportunity to get that ballot tallied.
For the I-Team, Lolita Lopez, NBC4 News.